Hello dear student, myself Miss Nehal Sakurkar, working in a department of pharmacology. Today we are starting with our next chapter, that is antibiotic affecting the protein synthesis. What are the antibiotics which affect the protein synthesis? These are the antibiotics which affect the protein synthesis process of the bacteria, and hence it will inhibit the bacterial growth. Example, tetracycline, aminoglycosides and microbialide antibiotics. In that first example, tetracycline. Why it is called as a tetracycline? Because it contains in its structure the four cyclic ring, which is obtained from the soil actinomycete. Then, why considering the classification of tetracycline? The tetracycline is classified into two categories. That is, first, according to its source, it is categorized into naturally occurring tetracycline, that is tetracycline, chlorotetracycline, semi-synthetic derivative and various prodrugs. What is meant by prodrugs? When administered inside the tetracycline bind to 30S ribosomal unit, which resulting into the inhibition of binding attachment of a amino acid tRNA to receptor A site. This A site it fails to bind with the amino acid. Hence, the peptide chain it fails to grow because there is no sliding of this amino acid chain toward the next position, and hence it will inhibit the protein synthesis process. It is the overall their antimicrobial spectrum, resistance, adverse drug reaction, interaction and uses of the tetracycline. The major tetracycline interaction which is notable is the tetracycline is having the tendency to form the chelate with the ions, and hence it will form the complex like structure, and that structure is deposited into the teeth and bone. So it is avoided in a pregnancy to avoid the faulty teeth and bone formation inside the baby or fetus. Then next antibiotic which affect the protein synthesis is the aminoglycoside. Aminoglycoside, these are the group of natural and semi-synthetic antibiotics having polybasic amino groups, that is linked with the glycoside, two or more amino sugar or residue. Streptomycin was the first member which is discovered in 1944 by the Waxman and his colleague, which is having the aminoglycoside antibiotic. It is assumed active against the tubercular bacilli. All aminoglycosides are produced by the soil actinomycete derivative. What are the common property of the aminoglycoside antibiotic? Most of the time, all aminoglycoside antibiotics are possesses the similar property, which are all amino acids are used as a sulfate salt because it will having the high solubility and the high stability. Then when that is available in a solution form, it is having the ionized condition and it is not absorbed orally. It will distribute only extracellularly and it will not penetrate the blood-brain barrier. All amino acids are excreted in the urine by the glomerular filtration. All aminoglycosides are bactericidal and having more activity against the alkaline pH. They are act by interfering with the bacterial protein synthesis. All aminoglycosides are having the action against the aerobic gram-negative bacilli. It does not inhibit the anaerobic condition bacteria. These are only partially produces the cross resistance amongst them. They are have relatively narrow safety of margin. Hence, there should be the dose calculation is properly to avoid the side effect. And next property or last property. All aminoglycoside is having the tendency to produce the ototoxicity and the nephrotoxicity. Means there is a hearing problem and there is a nephron toxicity is occur. Then by considering the classification of aminoglycoside antibiotic, their action is considered depending upon their route of administration. Some of the systemically active antibiotics or aminoglycoside antibiotics means these are antibiotics are taken from the oral route or any other route, but it should show the its effect systemically. Then some of the aminoglycoside which will be applied topically, these are the topically administering aminoglycoside derivative. Aminoglycoside that will through porine channel, it will diffuse across the outer coat membrane of the gram-negative bacilli. Then, entry from the periplasmic to the cytoplasmic membrane, and hence after the entry inside the cell, it will link with the electron transport chain by the carrier-mediated. Its penetration is dependent polarity of the membrane and the oxygen content, and this process is active process. Then aminoglycoside or streptomycin is binds with the 30S ribosomes, while other all aminoglycosides will bind to additionally 30S ribosome along with the 50S ribosomal subunit. Then after the binding with the 50S subunit or 30S ribosomal subunit or both ribosomal subunit, it will freeze the initiation process of the protein synthesis by preventing the polysomes formation and promote their disaggregation to the monomer. Then only one ribosome is attached to each strands of the mRNA, and hence it will inhibit the protein synthesis, means it will prevent the elongation chain of the protein or amino acids. Additionally, it will, after the binding with the 30S ribosomes or 50S subunit, it will resulting the causing the disorientation of the mRNA codon recognition. Wrong amino acids are entered in the peptide chain, and peptide chain abnormal length are produced. Means after the binding of the drug with the ribosomes 30 or 50 subunits, there is a wrong codon is attached to the mRNA, and which will be resulting into the length is get inhibited or short length amino acids are produced. Due to that misleading code or faulty amino acid formation, it will inhibit the protein synthesis process. Ultimately, all the aminoglycoside is anti-inhibit the protein synthesis. It is a overall antibacterial spectrum resistance, adverse drug reaction interaction, and uses of the aminoglycosides antibiotics. Their major side effect is it will be resulting into the ototoxicity and the nephrotoxicity as the side effect. The next amino acid which will be inhibit the protein synthesis is the macrolide. Macrolide, these are the antibiotic having the macrocyclic lactone ring attached to one or more deoxy sugar, which are specially active against the gram-positive microorganism. While the classification of a macrolide antibiotics are classified into macrolide antibiotic and ketolides antibiotics. Macrolide antibiotics are, these are contain the 40 membered ring, lactone ring in its structure, example erythromycin and clarithromycin. And some of the macrolide antibiotic contain the 50 membered lactone ring in its structure, example is erythromycin. Then ketolide antibiotics is telithromycin. Then before considering the mechanism of action, we will know what is the common procedure of the protein synthesis inside the bacteria. In bacteria, peptide bond formation between the newly attached amino acid and the nascent peptide chain of a receptor A site, which will be resulting into the elongation peptide chain is translocated back to peptide P site, making A site available for the next codon of the tRNA attachment. Ribosomes fails to move along with the mRNA exposure to next codon, that will be interfere with the translocation and inhibit the protein synthesis. When we administered the erythromycin or any macrolide antibiotic, it will enter into the bacterial cell wall by the active transport. It will combine with the 50S ribosomal subunit and block these steps, which is step that making a A site available for the next codon, means it will block the A site which will be available for the next codon, and hence there is a blocking the further steps of the protein synthesis. Then next, it is a all antibacterial spectrum resistance, adverse drug reaction interaction, and uses of the macrolide antibiotics. These are the various references used for the preparation of this slide, and thank you.